My name is Alex. I use he, him pronouns. I'm a trans man, and I make videos documenting my transition online. Well, I think just in general, there's been an explosion of trans creators online. I think YouTube is the perfect place to document a very physical journey, so that's great. I guess that's it. Like, I started making videos because people, like, when I looked online, people weren't producing that kind of content. And I didn't know what to do. Like, I didn't know what I should be doing in the NHS, or, like, I didn't know what path to take. So I think, yeah, it was kind of like a snowball of that. And especially, like, UK YouTubers, there weren't a lot of, like, trans guys in the UK making videos, especially on the NHS, and, like, especially younger trans people that maybe couldn't, like, medically transition just yet. So, yeah.
You also, like, when you first came here, you had, like, a much smaller audience. And then you fast forward to 2018, and you've got a book out, which is the best trans pun. It's very, very good. Quest for a Beard, excellent. What's that been like, having kind of, like, this career based around a part of your identity?
It's weird. Like, I don't know. I think you can never truly forget. Like, I can never truly forget that I'm trans. And, you know, choosing to put my transition online kind of, it's made my life very different, because now I can never be stealth, where, like, I'll go, like, I have a 9-to-5. So, like, never again will I be able to pretend that I'm cis, or, like, you know, try to pass as a cis man, because you Google my name and it all comes up. So, yeah, I've kind of, like, sacrificed that part of my life, but I wouldn't have it any other way, because I love doing this. And, like, even if my videos get 2 views, like, to me, it matters, you know? I'm not going to lie, I don't pay much attention to ads or, like, restrictions or anything. So while it
Have you got ad block?
Yes, but
you're part of the problem.
No, it's disabled on YouTube, I swear. No. Because of my 9-to-5, like, I don't really look at the dollar signs or anything like that. I just kind of want to make stuff because I want to make stuff. The thing that bothers me is that, like, knowing that maybe kids at school who are, like, Googling, am I trans or something like that, like, that's such a scary thing. Like, struggling with your gender is so hard. And if, like, those resources are taken away, I can't even imagine. Like, it hurts me, it upsets me, and that's the bit that bothers me, not the money or anything like that. I'd recommend Finn the Invincible on YouTube. He's a really small YouTuber. He's a trans man, but he's a lot older. And I think older trans people are kind of glossed over, because obviously if you look around, everybody here is so young.